So in my previous tutorial, we talked about how to best shoot time-lapse with your GoPro Hero 5 Black. Today, I want to cover the additional night time-lapse mode. Hence the name, it's for shooting time-lapses in low light conditions. We are not in the city, we are countryside and we can see the stars. So what we are trying to do is shoot a time-lapse of the night sky. First, let's turn on our GoPro, and my GoPro starts in movie mode because this is my default. So let's switch over to night-lapse mode. And here you can see that we have three settings to play with: the shutter speed, the interval between our shots, and the field of view, and we'll go through them now one by one. For shooting the night sky, I almost always go with the shutter speed of 30 seconds. Only if you have a lot of spill light, I would maybe try 20 seconds, but 30 seconds for a night sky shot is really the way to go. The interval between our shots needs to be higher than the shutter speed, obviously, and the GoPro gives you some options from 1 minute up to 60 minutes. I usually go with auto. Auto means that the GoPro will shoot a photo once it has finished shooting and processing the previous photo. In our case here, that'll be something around 30 seconds. You can choose whatever field of view you like, but I'd like to capture as much of the night sky as possible, so I always go with wide. Next, we swipe left and turn on ProTune, which gives us access to advanced settings that will come very handy for our little project here. I choose flat as the color profile, simply because I'm planning to edit the photos in Lightroom. If that's not what you're doing, I strongly recommend going with GoPro, as it usually gives you better results. For shooting the night sky, the only white balance I can recommend is 3000 Kelvin. Everything else gives you a reddish tint that I really don't like and I try to avoid. I usually try to keep the ISO as low as possible, but for shooting the night sky, setting the minimum ISO to 100 and the maximum ISO to 800 gave me the best results so far. For shooting the night sky, I keep exposure value compensation at 0. And since we are adding sharpness in post, I keep sharpness at low for now. The only other setting that I would recommend adjusting via GoPro app is turning spot metering off, so the auto exposure is based on the average of the whole scene rather than just the center of the image. And with that, let's get outside and let's prepare our GoPro for the shoot. Most importantly, you want to make sure that the camera is absolutely stable and not even the wind is shaking the camera. Remember, we are dealing with long exposure shots here and every little movement will ruin your shot. I recommend using either a GorillaPod or a heavy tripod. And then, since we are likely shooting throughout the night, I recommend getting a power bank and attach it to your GoPro. In order for us to plug in the USB cable of the power bank into our GoPro, we need to detach its side door, which means our GoPro isn't waterproof anymore. And this is exactly the reason why I wrapped everything in cling wrap, so our GoPro is protected against possible rain or dew in the morning. Now that we are done shooting, let's bring all the photos into Lightroom and let's pick the first one to edit. Just remember that these are not raw images that we are dealing with, so you can't pull and push the images too much, otherwise they will be definitely falling apart. We have slightly increased exposure and contrast, now let's bring down the highlights and open up the shadows. And then we increase the whites and we lower the blacks. Now let's slightly bring up clarity, and then we'll give our image a little more vibrance as well. Now let's have a look at the details of our image, and first of all let's increase sharpening, and usually I'm increasing the sharpening to around 60 to 70. Next, let's keep pressing the Alt key and we drag the masking slider to the right to make sure that we are only adding sharpness to the areas of the image that are shining through. Now we are adding noise reduction by dragging the luminance slider to the right, and here we go a little further than we would normally do to get a really smooth image. Now let's bring the details back up until we have an image that we are happy with, and most of the noise that we have in these type of images is color noise, so we'll set this to 100. And then finally, let's remove chromatic aberration and then we enable the profile correction for our GoPro Hero 5. Now let's copy all the changes that we've made to this image. Hit Command A to make sure that all the images are selected, and then let's sync all the changes across the images that we have. Now finally, let's export all our images, bring them into Final Cut Pro as you would normally do, and let's have a look at what we created together.
So here you have it, guys. This is my tutorial about how to best shoot night time lapses with your GoPro Hero 5 Black. If you guys enjoyed it, as always, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions or feedback, please leave a comment down below. And with that, I catch you guys in my next video.